So in the last class we have seen the three phase power measurement using two wattmeter method, okay, and we have proved that P is equals to W1 plus W2 is equals to root 3 EL IL cos phi, okay, root 3 EL IL cos phi is the total three phase power consumed in a three phase network, okay. But now I should be knowing what is cos phi, because cos phi, if I don't know what is the impedance of the load. Now suppose if I am using this two wattmeter method for measurement of three phase power in an induction motor, if I don't know what is the impedance of induction motor windings, I will not be knowing what is the and load, I will not be knowing what is the power factor, and moreover the load on induction motor is mechanical, which is independent of power factor. But induction motor is having power factor, but load on induction motor doesn't characterize with power factor. So therefore in such cases it is difficult to know what is power factor, okay. Hence I should be using the two watt meter readings itself to find the power factor of the system, okay. You take next expression for power factor, expression for power factor, okay. So we have W1 is equals to ELIL cos of 30 plus 5, ELIL cos of 30 plus 5, W2 is equals to ELIL cos of 30 minus 5, and W1 plus W2 is equals to root 3 ELIL cos 5, okay. Take W1 minus W2, I get here only, right? W1 minus W2 is equals to W1 minus W2 is equals to ELIL cos of 30 plus 5 minus ELIL cos of 30 minus 5, okay. Or this will be equals to ELIL cos of 30 plus 5 minus cos of 30 minus 5. It is cos of A plus B minus cos of A minus B. So cos of A plus B is cos A cos B minus sin A sin B. Cos of A minus B is cos A cos B plus sin A sin B. Okay, using those expressions here. So ELIL cos of A plus B, cos A cos B, that is cos 30 cos 5 minus sin A sin B, sin 30 sin 5 minus cos of A minus B, that is cos A cos B plus sin A sin B, cos 30 cos 5 minus sin A plus sin A sin B. But I have a minus sign out here, it will be minus sin A sin B. Minus sin 30 sin 5. So cos 30 cos 5 minus cos 30 cos 5 will get cancelled out. Okay. And what I get is W1 minus W2 is equals to ELIL minus ELIL 2 sin 30 sin 5 minus ELIL 2 into 1 by 2 sin 30 is half into sin 5 is equals to minus ELIL sin 5. So W1 minus W2 is minus ELIL sin 5. Now take ratio W1 minus W2 upon W1 plus W2. W1 minus W2 upon W1 plus W2. So that will come out W1 minus W2 upon W1 plus W2 is equal to, it is minus ELIL sin phi upon root 3 ELIL cos phi. So ELIL will cancel out, sin by cos is tan, so this will be equals to minus 1 by root 3 tan phi, okay, or phi is equals to, or first you take first step, tan phi is equals to, tan phi is equals to minus, it is W1 minus W2 upon W1 plus W2. So it is minus root 3 into W1 minus W2 divided by W1 plus W2. Okay, or phi is equals to tan inverse of minus root 3 W1 minus W2 upon W1 plus W2, and tan inverse of minus theta is nothing but tan theta, or tan inverse of minus value, sorry, not theta, tan inverse of minus value is equals to minus tan inverse of that value. So that is minus tan inverse root 3 W1 minus W2 divided by W1 plus W2. Therefore, power factor cos phi is equals to cos of phi is tan inverse, sorry, minus tan inverse root 3 W1 minus W2 divided by W1 plus W2. But cos of minus theta is cos theta. Okay? As cos of minus theta is equals to cos theta, because cos is any one function. Cos phi is equals to cos of tan inverse of root 3 W1 minus W2 upon W1 plus W2. Okay? And phi is equals to tan inverse of root 3 W1 minus W2 upon W1 plus W2. So this is the expression for power factor in a three phase circuit when we use two wattmeter method for measurement of three phase power, and this is the power factor angle phi. Okay, in the textbook you did not get minus sign here. Okay, because there W1 minus W1 was equals to ELIL cos of 30 minus phi, and W2 was ELIL cos of 30 plus phi. There is no change, absolutely there is no difference between the two derivations, both are exactly the same, because ultimately we reached the same value of cos phi and phi. Okay, so no need to get confused by going through this derivation and by going through the derivation that is given in the textbook. Both are exactly one and the same. You can use any derivation, this or from the textbook, for in your exam. Both will fetch you the same number of marks. Okay, so next is to get
the effect of power factor on the wattmeter readings. Okay, that we'll see in the next lecture video. Okay, thank you. Effect of power factor on wattmeter readings. Okay, now I got this expression of power factor. Now we'll see how the load power factor will affect on the way how the power these wattmeters will read. Okay, now what happens if load power factor is 0? What happens if load power factor is 1? What happens if load power factor is between 0 to 1 or 0 to 0.5? What happens at 0.5? We will see. Okay, there are three cases where we will study the effect of power factor on the load. Effect of effect of load power factor on wattmeter readings. Effect of load power factor on wattmeter readings. We have W1 is equals to root 3 EL IL cos phi and W2 is equals to W1 is equals to EL IL cos phi cos of 30 plus phi. Yeah, root 3 EL IL cos phi is W1 plus W2. Sorry. And W2 is equals to EL IL cos of 30 minus phi. Okay. Now case one. When power factor is equals to 1. Okay, or unity power factor. So that is cos phi is equals to 1. Okay, therefore what is phi is equals to? Therefore phi is equals to 0. Okay, cos phi is equals to 1, therefore phi is equals to 0. So it is evident that when the power factor is 1, that is cos 0 is 1. And what is 0? Phi is equals to 0 indicates there is no phase difference between the voltage and the current in the given circuit. Substitute phi is equals to 0 in W1 and W2. Okay. Therefore W1 is equals to EL IL cos of 30 plus 0. And W2 is equals to EL IL cos of 30 minus 0. It is EL IL cos of direct level, right? EL IL cos of 30. So cos 30 is root 3 by 2. So root 3 by 2 EL IL. Okay. Root 3 by 2 EL IL. Root 3 by 2 EL IL and root 3 by 2 EL IL. So when power factor is exactly equals to 1, both the wattmeters will read positive and equal. Okay. So therefore, both wattmeters read positive and equal. Okay, because W1 plus W2 is total power. It is measured by two wattmeters. the complete power that is given to the circuit is consumed. Complete power that is given to the circuit is that is what is complete power given to the circuit, root 3 L I L. Okay, so that is measured by two wattmeters. Therefore, one wattmeter will measure half, one wattmeter will measure half. That is the understanding. Okay, now case 2. Second case, when power factor is equals to 0.5. Second case, when power factor is equals to 0.5. So when power factor is 0.5, the power factor angle phi is equals to 60 degrees. Okay, phi is equals to 60 degrees. Substitute value phi in W1 and W2. Therefore, W1 is equals to EL IL cos of 30 plus 60. W2 is equals to EL IL cos of 30 minus 60. Cos of 30 plus 60 is cos 90 and cos 90 is 0. Therefore, W1 will read 0. Okay, ELIL cos of 30 minus 5, it is cos of minus 30. So cos of minus 30 is nothing but cos 30. It is equals to root 3 by 2 ELIL. Okay. Sorry, yes, it is 30 minus 60 is root 3 by 2 ELIL. So one of the wattmeter is reading 0. One of the wattmeter is reading positive. One watt meter reads 0. Okay. Now third case 3, when power factor is equals to 0. When power factor is equals to 0. Cos phi is equals to 0, therefore phi is equals to 90 degrees. Okay. So it is W1 is equals to EL IL cos of 30 plus 90, 30 minus 90. So this is equals to EL IL cos of 30 plus 90. So cos of 30 plus 90 is cos of 120. So cos of 120 is equals to minus half into ELIL. Minus half into ELIL. And W2 is equals to cos of 30 minus 90, it is cos of minus 60. That is cos 60. Okay. So therefore, it is half ELIL. Okay. Half ELIL. So here, one watt meter reads negative and equal to second watt meter. Okay. So one watt meter is minus half ELIL, second watt meter is plus half ELIL. So one watt meter is reading negative, other watt meter is reading positive. Okay. Now, whenever we connect the load, there is no guarantee that the load power factors are only these three values. That is only 0, only 0.5 and only 1. The load power factor can be any value between 0 to 1. Okay. And you observe watt meter 1, W1. Wattmeter 1 is the wattmeter which is reading the values from positive to negative range. Okay, it is reading the values from minus 1 by 2 ELIL to plus root 3 by 2 ELIL. It is the range of the wattmeter 1. watt meter 2 is always reading positive. Okay, neither it is reading 0 nor it is reading negative, it is always reading positive. Okay, so watt meter 1 is the one which is changing its behavior or changing its range of readings, whereas watt meter 2 is always positive. Watt meter 2 is always reading positive. Its range is 1 by 2 ENIL to root 3 by 2 ENIL. That is the value it can measure if there are two watt meters connected. Okay. Now, what if the power factor is between 0.5 to 1? At exactly 1, both the watt meters read positive and equal, root 3 by 2 ENIL. Now, what if power factor is less than 1 but greater than 0.5? Because at exactly 0.5, watt meter 1 reads 0. Okay? So, here we will summarize. Because I have to see how to get the negative reading of watt meter. If you use analog watt meter, okay, then the minimum value what it can read will be 0. So it doesn't understand the negative numerology. Watt meters do not understand what is negative means. Negative here in the sense direction is opposed. Power cannot be negative. Power can be only positive. Okay, there is no direction for the power. Negative indicates the direction. Direction in the sense, in the electric circuit, we assume or we consider positive power is nothing but the power that is flowing from source to load. When I come with negative power, I consider the power that will be flowing from load to source. That will happen if the load is capacitive. If the load is capacitive, my power flow will be from load to source. If the load is inductive and resistive, power flow will be from source to load. Okay. Now, for power factor is equals to 0.5 to 1. So what we can see here is, or for power factor is equals to 1, both watt meters read positive and equal. Both watt meters read positive and equal. Then for power factor is equals to 0.5 to 1, for power factor is equals to 0.5 to 1. Okay, at exactly equal to 1, both will read equal, but between 0.5 to 1, okay, both will read positive. Though may not be equal, both watt meters read positive. Okay. At power factor equals to 0.5, one watt meter reads 0. One watt meter reads 0. Then for power factor 0 to 0.5, between 0 and 0.5, excluding 0 and 0.5, okay, one watt meter reads negative. So the watt meter that is reading 0 will read negative. One watt meter is improving or changing its value or readings from negative to positive when the power factor is changing from 0 towards 1. if initial power factor is 0 and final power factor is 1, okay? Because power factor may not remain same for all the systems or circuits in an electric circuit. The power factor will go on improving as I go on increasing the load of the system. Initially the power factor will be less, okay? As I go on increasing, the power factor is also going on increasing, okay? Because the working component of the current goes on increasing, therefore power factor also goes on increasing. Hence, as I go on increasing the load on certain type of machines, the power factor will also go on increasing. So initially, one wattmeter may be reading negative. As the load goes on increasing, that wattmeter will start reading towards positive, and it has to cross zero. So the wattmeter that reads 0 at 0.5 will read negative when power factor is below 0.5. Okay. And power factor is 0, okay? Both wattmeters read equal value. Both wattmeter read equal value, but one reads negative. Okay. So now I should be knowing how exactly I have to note down the negative readings of wattmeters. Because negative readings of wattmeters, we don't get directly in its indication. The wattmeters what we are using are called indicating instruments. Ammeter, voltmeter, wattmeters, these are all indicating instruments. So, when you see, basically, the indicating instruments don't know how to read the, especially analog meters, cannot read the negative unless it is a galvanometer. Only galvanometer has got the center point, zero is at center, and it can read on either side. Okay, then we can fix there what is positive side and what is negative side of the galvanometer. But here in case of our regular wattmeters, if it would have been a regular class, I would have taken wattmeter to the classroom itself, but unfortunately we can't do that now. So if you take this as a wattmeter, okay, I will be having a scale here. Okay. And the minimum value what wattmeter can read is 0. So the pointer can point the minimum 0 value. It cannot point below 0. So it is very difficult to get the negative, or it is impossible to get the negative values, because minimum value itself is 0. Okay. Whenever the power has to be indicated by this wattmeter, it has to deflect towards right. It cannot deflect below 0. Then what arrangement I can do? Okay, so for that we have to see what is wattmeter. We know this is the wattmeter connection. This is M, L, C and V. Okay. I am taking single phase connection, but this condition will not arise in single phase power measurement. This condition will arise only in three phase two wattmeter power measurement. Okay. Now, if the current flows in the wattmeter from M to L and voltage across, this is phase and neutral, and voltage across potential coil, that is CV, is in this direction, then my wattmeter will read positive. Okay, my watt meter will read positive. Now you may ask, in negative half cycle, the potential will be minus n plus. Yes? During positive half cycle, P is at positive or higher potential, n is at lower potential. Plus means higher potential, minus means lower potential. Plus doesn't mean positive charge, minus doesn't mean negative charge. Okay? So in my electrical science, plus means higher potential point. Minus means lower potential point. Plus doesn't mean positive charges. Okay? So during positive half cycle, phase will be at higher potential point, neutral will be at lower potential point. Okay? Then definitely I assume current is flowing in this direction. During negative half cycle, phase will be at lower potential and neutral will be at higher potential. Then during negative half cycle, current will be in opposite direction. Okay? So, when voltage and current are simultaneously changing their polarities, minus into minus will become plus. Current is also minus, voltage is also minus. Minus voltage into minus current is positive power. Okay? So, it won't affect. But now, if I want to read the negative values of the wattmeter, now I will get to know that when I connect the wattmeter for the power measurement, and if it starts kicking back, if the pointer starts kicking back below zero value, then it is understood that power factor of the load is less than 0.5. Okay? In that case, what I have to do is, either I have to interchange the current coil connections, or I have to interchange the potential coil connections. Okay? Either I have to interchange the current coil connections, or I have to interchange the potential coil connections. That is, simply replace the connections of M and L. Now make this M and this L. Okay? Make this M, this L. What does it mean? Power flow is, when watt meter reads negative, it means power flow is in that meter, power flow is in opposite direction. That is, it is flowing from load to source. Okay? So therefore, interchange M and L connections. Or, keep M and L connections or current coil connections same. Okay? Interchange C and V connections. So either I have to interchange the current coil connections or I have to interchange potential coil connections. Don't do both. If you do both, again it will be showing negative values only. I have to interchange, I have to reverse the direction of current or the direction of potential difference. If direction of current and potential difference are both interchanged simultaneously, the effect is same. Okay? So therefore, here, when any of the wattmeter reads negative, then for that wattmeter, I have to either change or interchange the current coil connections or I have to interchange the potential coil connections. If you do that, then that wattmeter which was kicking back below zero will start reading above zero, and that value should be taken as minus. If suppose that this wattmeter is now after interchanging showing say some around 50 watts. That is actually in my equation minus 50 watts. And suppose the other wattmeter is reading say 150 watts. Then my total 3 phase power is W1 plus W2. 150 minus 50, that is 100 watts. Okay, that is the power consumed, not the power delivered. Power delivered is always EL into IL. 3 into EPH into IPH or root 3 ELIL. Okay? This is how we have to use the two wattmeters for measurement of three phase power. Okay? This is the end of analytical part of the three phase circuits. Now we will move to solving the problems on three phase circuit. Okay? So first we will take very simple problems on star and delta connections, because we should understand the fundamental concepts and the use of expressions or equations for my problem solving. Okay, so very simple problem I will take. In a star connected three phase circuit shown, find line and phase currents. Find line and phase currents. Line and phase voltages. Find line and phase currents. Line and phase voltages. Okay. Three phase power consumed. Three phase power consumed. Okay. It is not mentioned with the two watt meter method or what. Okay. So we will simply see how conceptually we can get the things which are asked for the calculation. Okay. It is star connected circuit, already it is mentioned. So I will be it is a balanced star circuit. Okay. So this is the given circuit. Okay. Now for this, I have to find out line voltage, line current, phase current, and power consumed by the circuit. Okay. It is given, nothing it is mentioned, line voltage or phase voltage. By seeing the circuit itself, now I should understand 440 volts is line to line voltage. It is not mentioned what is the voltage between, let us take this as A or A, B and C. It is not mentioned what is the voltage between B and C and C and A. It is evident and understood that voltage between B and C is also 440, between C and A is also 440. So here EL is equals to 440 volts. Here EL is equals to 440 volts. Okay. Now what is current? Let this be IA, line current IB and IC. In star, line current equals to phase current or phase current equal to line current. Once I find phase current, then automatically I will get line current. Okay. So EL is equals to 440 volts. Therefore, what is EPH? It is EL by root 3. It is star. So, I have to use equations, relations of voltages and currents that we have reduced for the star connection. Okay. So, EPH equals to EL by root 3. That is 440 volts divided by root 3. So, EPH will be, I think, 440 by root 3 is around 254 volts.
Okay.
It is 254 volts. Yeah, 254.03.
Okay.
So EPH is 254 volts. See, I cannot directly calculate IL. Generally, whenever we want to calculate the line current for three-phase system, first I calculate the phase current. Then, if it is star connected, phase current is equal to line current. If it is delta connected, line current is equal to root 3 times the phase current. Okay. So, first find out phase current. Now, IPH is equals to, I can write EPH by ZPH. IPH is equals to EPH by ZPH. And what is ZPH? Sorry, EPH. Now this is EPH. Between line and neutral or phase and neutral. That is called EPH. So EPH, voltage across phase impedance, divided by phase impedance, will get the current through that impedance. And what is ZPH? ZPH is 2 ohm and 5 ohm. It is inductive reactance. Okay. Therefore, it is 2 plus j 5 ohms. Here, by default, use j method. 2 plus j 5 ohms. Now, therefore, IPH is equals to, I will rub this statement. It is EPH by ZPH. EPH is 254 volts divided by ZPH, 2 plus J5. Now substitute this in calculator under complex mode. 254 divided by 2 plus 5i. I will get 17.51. Okay. Minus J 43.8. Amperes, but keep the current in polar form. Okay, please keep the current and voltages in polar form. It is 47.16 at an angle minus 68.2 amperes. Okay, so IPH is 47.16. at an angle minus 68.2 amperes. In AC circuit, always the currents are mentioned along with their angles. Even voltages are to be mentioned, but the voltage given is 440 volts. The phase angle of initial phase angle of voltage is not mentioned. So implicitly it is understood that my voltage is at 0 degrees. Okay. Therefore, in star, IL is equals to IPH. Is it? In star connection, IL is equals to IPH, and that is equals to 47.16 at an angle minus 68.2 amperes, 2 degrees amperes. Okay, what is power consumed? Three phase power consumed. P is equals to root 3 EL IL cos phi. I know EL and IL. I should find what is cos phi. And always remember, cos phi has to be calculated per phase basis. Okay, we should be finding it per phase because it is balanced. Okay, so when it is balanced, it is per phase. So cos phi is equals to RPH by ZPH. Okay. RPH by ZPH. R by Z. Ratio of resistance to impedance is my power factor. So RPH by ZPH. Okay. RPH is 2 ohms. ZPH I should calculate. Okay. Or if you don't want to calculate, you can, this is one case, RPH by ZPH you can do. Now if you don't want to calculate, cos phi is also given as cos of tan inverse of XPH by RPH. Directly you will get it. So cos phi is equals to cos of tan inverse of XPH is 5, RPH is 2. So tan inverse of 5 by 2 is 2.5. 0.37. So cos phi is 0.37 lagging. Because it is inductive load, it is lagging power factor. Okay. Therefore, power consumed, P is equals to root 3 EL. EL is 440 volts into IL. It is 47.16. Please remember, don't add the angle in the expression of power. Power has to be used with only the magnitude of the current. Because power is a scalar, I should not be adding the angle to that. Okay? Into cos phi, 0.37. Okay? This is 13.35 kilowatts. Okay, 13.35 kilowatts. So this is how I will be calculating the three phase power in a given three phase network. Okay. So now the same numerical we do using the delta connection. Okay. Or I think it is time for next class. Another 5 to 7 minutes. I will give you this numerical. You please try it out. Okay. Same, find, okay, line and phase voltages, line and phase current, and three phase power consumed. So here three phase power consumed will be greater than 13.35 kilowatts, definitely. Okay, why? In the discussion of star and delta, we have seen that whether we connect the system in star or whether we connect the system in delta, the power consumed will remain same. Now, the same impedance per phase of 2 plus J5 ohms was connected in star and the power consumed came out to be 13.35 kilowatts. Okay. Now, same impedance is connected at delta across the same line voltage. But the power consumed will increase here. Why it will increase? When you calculate, when you get justified that power consumed will increase, in next class I will be telling why the power increased in the second problem when compared to first problem. Okay. So power consumed is equals to root 3 NIL cos phi. See, power consumed can be directly given by using the I square R. Power consumed is always equal to I square R. Now P is equals to, I can also write 3 into IPH square into RPH, because IPH square into RPH is power consumed in one phase in star connection. Go back to star connection. In one phase multiplied by 3, it will be 3 phase. Now what is it? Is 3 into IPH was 47.16 square into RPH was 2. It came out to be 13.344 kilowatts. Here I have approximated to 35. It is actually 13.3487 kilowatts. Here it is 13.344 kilowatts. So hardly I will get a difference of 4 watts. So power consumed is always in resistance. You should be nailing it in your mind. Okay, you should always remember that power consumed is always, and it is only in resistive part. Okay, so this is equals to 13.344 kilowatts. In any circuit, not only in three phase, even in single phase, power consumed is EI cos phi or I square R. Okay, you can take power consumed as EI cos phi or I square R. Here you can take power consumed as root 3 NIL cos phi or 3 into IPH square into RPH. Both are same, because the reactive part will never consume any power. It is only the resistive part of the load that will always consume the power. Okay, so this already we have discussed even in the regular class. Okay, why resistance consume power and why reactance will not consume power. Okay, so this is, you please try this problem, and definitely you will get power consumed more than 13.35 kilowatts. Why so? I will tell you in the next class. Okay, so this is all for today. In the next class we'll see another few examples on two watt meter method, and we'll end this part of the syllabus. Okay, thank you.